Hi there, my name is Simon, and in this video, I'm going to show you step by step how to create, verify, and secure your Coinbase account. I'm going to show you everything on my computer, so all you need to do is follow along with this video. So let's not waste any time and get started right away. Okay, so the first step obviously is to go ahead and sign up for a new Coinbase account. And the cool thing with Coinbase is they currently have this referral program going on where if you already have a Coinbase account, you get a special referral link that you can then send out to other people. And once they use your specific link and deposit $100 and buy Bitcoin or any other cryptocurrency with that $100, then you will get $10 as a reward. And the person who uses your link also gets $10 deposited into their account once they have made the purchase of buying crypto for at least $100. And as you can see here, you have 180 days to actually go ahead and buy cryptocurrency. So it's not a rush. You don't need to do it like in the next week or something. But so what I've done is I put my personal referral link down below in the video description. So you can use that if you want to, then you will get $10 and I will get $10. Or if you already have friends who already have a Coinbase account, you can also ask them to send you their link and then they will get the $10. So once you're actually on the Coinbase website, then you can go ahead and type in your first name, your last name, your email address, and choose a password. And then you want to make sure to tick this box here that you're 18 or older, and then click on create account right here. And then we'll get to this screen right here where we're just going to click on next. And then here you can go ahead and read their private policy if you want to, and then click on I acknowledge right here. Then on this step, they basically ask you if it's okay for them to send you promotional emails. I usually just click on no because I already get a lot of emails and I don't need to see any promotions or stuff like that. So if you want to see that, you can click on yes, but I'm going to click on no right here. Now we're done with the first part, and the next step is to verify our email address that we have used to sign up for Coinbase. So what we have to do now is sign up into the email inbox of the email address that we have used and then look for an email from Coinbase. So this is what the email will look like that you'll be getting from Coinbase. And all you have to do here is click on verify email address, like this button that you see right here. And once you click there, then it will take you back to the Coinbase website and we can move on with the signup process. Now, the next step is to set up two-step verification, which is like another security measure. What that basically means is that when you want to sign into your Coinbase account later on, you will not only need to enter your password, but you'll also need to enter a so-called one-time password that Coinbase will send you to your phone via text message. So just type in your phone number right here and then click on send code on the bottom. And once you've done that, then you'll be getting a code sent to your phone via text message. So all you have to do is type in that code in this field right here. And once you've done that, click on submit. So then we have to select our citizenship. So you can just click on the scroll down button here and select your country and click on submit. And then you have to verify your identity. Now, make sure you actually type in your correct information in all these fields right here, because they will kind of cross-check it with your driver's license or your personal ID card later on. So make sure you type in all the information here and then click on continue. Then they need to know about how much cryptocurrency do you expect to trade per year and also what industry you are working in. So select that here and then click on submit. And then here we have to confirm all the personal information that we have typed in before, showing them some kind of official ID document, like a passport, a driver's license, or a national ID card. So it's up to you which one you want to use. Personally, I have used a driver's license. And then on the next step, you can decide on how you want to show them this document. So you can use your webcam of your desktop computer or of your laptop, or you could also use your mobile camera. If you choose this one, then they will send you a link to your phone and then you can click on that link and you can basically scan your document using your camera on your mobile phone, or you could just upload a file that you already have sitting on your computer. What I've done is I've used my webcam, so I can just hold up my ID card into the webcam. So I've done that. And then obviously it asks you if Coinbase can access your camera. So in order for that to work, you have to click allow right here. And once you have scanned in your front side and your back side, of your ID card, then it will take like a couple of seconds until your ID document is verified. So this is the screen that you should see then. And then on the next step, once it's verified, you should see this screen right here that you're verified and you can now add a bank card or a credit card. So here in the next step, you can add a credit card. So what they want to do is basically already set you up with a credit card, so it's even easier later on to purchase your first Bitcoin or any other cryptocurrency. But more on how you should buy your cryptocurrency later on in the tutorial. So type in your name on the card and all your credit card details in here and then click on add card. Awesome. So now we've successfully created our new Coinbase account. So let's move on and talk about the security. So to increase security, you want to go to the top right corner where you see your name right here and then click there and then go to settings right here. And then here we're going to click on security right there. So with the sign up process, we have already set up our phone number. So it already has set up a two-step verification for us using text messages. So when we sign into Coinbase, we have to not only enter our password, we also have to enter the one-time password that you will be getting with the phone number. But actually, this is not very secure, as you can also see here. It's only moderately secure. And the reason is because there's something called SIM swapping. This is where like criminals, they get access to your text messages so they can actually get access to that one-time password. So when they actually have your actual Coinbase password and also have access to your text messages, then they'll easily be able to get into your Coinbase account, which is why I highly recommend to set up another way of two-factor authentication using the Authenticator, which is like different apps like Authy or Google Authenticator, or actually use a hardware security key that basically means that you can only access your Coinbase account once this security key is plugged in. So personally, I'm currently using the Authenticator method because I think that's already pretty secure, because when you use that method, then people can only access your, or you can only access your Coinbase account when you have your physical mobile device, which is mostly your phone or your iPad or wherever you want to download that Authenticator application. I've actually ordered this hardware device as well, so it's not arrived yet, but that's probably something I'm going to do in the future to keep my account even more safe. It's like a YubiKey. If you're interested in that, I'll leave a link down below in the video description where you can get these. But for this tutorial, I'm going to move on and show you how to do it with Authenticator. So to set up the two-factor authentication using the Authenticator application, we have to first click on select right here. And then we'll be getting a code sent to us via text message that we'll be getting on our phone. And then all you have to do here is type in that code that you'll be getting right in this field to just kind of confirm that it's actually you. So I'm just going to type it in right now. And then once you've done that, click on confirm right here. And then we'll get to this screen right here. So the next step is to scan this QR code that we see right here using our Authenticator application. So if you don't already have an Authenticator application like Google Authenticator or Authy, I'm going to now show you on my phone how to download that application. And then I'm going to show you how to scan this code and set up everything using your Authenticator application. So once you're on your phone, you want to go to the App Store if you have an iPhone, or to the Google Play Store if you have an Android phone. And then you want to go to the search bar and type in, and like I said, there's multiple apps out there. I know Authy is one, so Authy would be a possibility. Or you could also use Google Authenticator, which is the one that I use, and just download this application. I have already downloaded Google Authenticator, so I'm not going to download it again. But you can download it, install it, and then once you open it, as you can see for my application, I already have a couple of one-time passwords set up for different accounts. For you, it's probably going to say something like set up your account. And what you want to do here is just click through the menu until you see an option to scan a new QR code. So once you see that option, click on scan new QR code. And for me, I'm just going to go to the plus sign here on the bottom and click on scan a QR code. And then you want to go ahead and scan the QR code that you see on your Coinbase account right now. And just like that, you have set up a new one-time password for your Coinbase account. And as you can see, every 30 seconds here, it actually changes the one-time password. So you want to make sure to actually enter the code that you see right here before the time runs out. So what you want to do is go back to your Coinbase account and then type in the exact password that you see currently on your screen. For me, it's 025686. So let's click on enable before the time runs out right here. And just like that, we have set up two-factor authentication using the Authenticator application. So now in the future, when you want to sign into your Coinbase account, after you have entered your password, it's going to ask you for the one-time password. And that's when you want to grab your phone, open the Authenticator application, and then you can enter the password that you see on your Authenticator application, and then you'll get access to your Coinbase account. And again, the advantage is that people can only access your Coinbase account and get access to your cryptocurrency when they have your password for your Coinbase account and also your mobile device. And this is very unlikely to happen. So this is a lot more secure than using the text message two-factor authentication. All right, so that's exactly how to set up your Coinbase account. This was actually a segment of my complete Coinbase tutorial that is also available here on YouTube. So if you want to learn more about Coinbase and how to actually trade cryptocurrency on the platform, then I suggest to check out my complete tutorial. I'll leave a link to that down below in the video description. If you found this video helpful, make sure to click that thumbs up button down below. That would really help out my YouTube channel. And also leave me a comment down below if you have any questions whatsoever. Also, if you want to see more videos just like this one, make sure you also subscribe to the channel. And with that being said, thank you very much for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.